government that we are doing questions conduct. We would like to be conducted. Which are starting with the. This is Joel Kakuma. Which language would you like your work to be conducted in? Rather than to think that. I remember the point is in. English. But as I said, the constitution gives you a right.
Not so it is the intent I was going to talk to them in the morning before they would have gone to the court. But unfortunately, I did not get the permission. And I cannot go against the order. So I'm just requesting the court and tell them that it's in the interest of justice for me to effectively represent these people. I get a copy of the charge sheet, although it has not yet been read, and I talk to them. I think these other things, whether they want to object to members or not, I can also give them answers, because you see, the constitution of court is by law. So you can't just wake up today and you object to a member, and then maybe court will not sit again. So I'm just suggesting for 30 minutes. I'm not asking. This, I talk to them. And then we come to court when they have the confidence and when I also have the confidence. I'm just making a passionate plea, my Lord Chairman. And then I think it's very important if an advocate goes to court and proceeds with the king.
My Lord Chairman, I don't know what he means. A judge sheet, you are not being judged. And a judge sheet becomes a judge sheet when the chairman has been. I think they will do it through the privilege. The charges the chairman, after reading the charges, signs, and then counsel will proceed from there. I think so far we have a lot of charges. It's just a block.
Okay. It's okay, but still now, even if there is no charge, even if there is nothing, it is prudent, my Lord Chairman and members, and gentlemen. That's me as a lawyer. I cannot just come to the first time and start representing this
people. I was even before I left the interview.
No, just talking to my clients, even if it's 10 minutes, I would appreciate it because it's
easy. But this left, I was doing
nothing. Yeah, but not that. Just talking to them, even if it's 5 minutes, it's very, very important for me as an advocate.
Very, very important.
Because they really, it's absolutely important. I'm just interested.
Okay, counsel, we're granting you 5 minutes. You can talk to them in the court. They should be alone with them, man. No problem. Now I think he wants them to say, no, this court should not try us. But all the same, court contempt will take place. Is it contempt of court or court contempt? It's called what? Is it court contempt?
Contempt of court.
Contempt of court. They kidnapped him. Don't you remember the other don't you remember the other Somali who was the kid? He was married without underpants. They kidnap people, taking them to Rwanda. They are officers who escaped from Rwanda. They kidnapped them, took them there. Without the consent of the government. Contempt of court, Or court contempt?
Contempt of court.
Contempt of court. On contempt of court, because they will not. ADC, you give me my papers.
Okay.
But these gadgets, someone can come and close them first. Because Anna Mugisha is hearing what I'm talking.
You hold on, yeah.
Thank you.
Let's proceed.
We are very grateful to be given this time to
when you have to get to the position of God, that is same thing. You're a Duma. Let's see if you're a Duma. You are the position against the state of the labor of God. Nixon, Agassiz, Kahanga, Jerry, Victor, Jenny. No, no, Victor. Maybe your son, Sister, police, Magadha, James, Larry, Victor.
No,
Victor. Maybe your son, Sister, police, Agassiz, and the Victor, Jerry, Victor.
No, Victor, my Lord, Jackson.
Maybe your son, Sister, police, Agassiz, and the
okay, before we proceed, we have has a phone on, put it in silence. We continue receiving your messages and calls. Don't disrupt our proceedings. I'll read the charge sheet. The Republic of Uganda, Uganda People Defense Forces, in a general court martial holding at Makindi, criminal case number UPDF/GMC/019/2017, charge sheet, Uganda versus accused one, A/959, Senior Commissioner of Police, Joel Aguma, a male adult of sound mind, age 46 years, Senior Commissioner of Police, a person subjected to military law by virtue of Section 119, Subsection 1, Clause H, Clause I of Uganda Police Defense Force Act of 2005. Accused number two, Senior Superintendent of Police, Nixon Agazire Karuhanga, made alert of sound mind, age 47 years, a senior police officer, a person subject to military law, by virtue of Section 119, Subsection 1, Clause H, Clause I, of Uganda Police Defense Act of 2005. Accused number 3, M/2041, Detective Assistant of Police, Maganda James, a male adult of sound mind, age 38 years, a person subject to military law by virtue of Section 119, Subsection 1, Clause H, Clause I, of UPDF Act of 2005. Accused number 4, A/1257, Detective Assistant Inspector of Police, Atwebire Benon, male adult of sound mind, age 35 years, A person subject to mutual law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I of UPDF Act of 2005. Accused number 5. Number 37496, Detective Sergeant Tumkunde Abel, a male adult, age 35 years, a person subject to military law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I of UPDF Act of 2005. Accused number 6, number 016, Special Police Constable Kakende Faisal, a male adult of sound mind, age 38 years, person subject to military law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I of UPDF Act 2005. Accused number 7, number 40223, Detective Coppolo was Quarisima Amon, a male adult of sound mind, 35 years, a person subject to military law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I, of the Uganda Police Defense Force Act of 2005. Accused number 8, Rotangwira Rene, male adult of sound mind, age 42 years, Rwandese by origin, a person subject to military law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I of UPDF Act of 2005. Accused number 9, Bahati Mugenga Pacific, alias Ilunga Monga, male adult of sound mind, age 35 years, Congolese by origin, a person subject to military law by virtue of section 119, subsection 1, clause H, clause I of UPDF Act of 2005. Sentence of offense. I mean, statement of offense. Count 1. Kidnapping contrary to section 242 of the Penal Code Act, Cap 120. Particulars of the offense. A stroke 959, Senior Commissioner of Police Joel Aguma, Senior Superintendent of Police Nixon Agusire Kaluanga, M stroke 0141, Detective Assistant Superintendent of Police Maganda James, A1257, Detective Assistant Inspector of Police Atwebire Benon, Number 37496, Detective Sergeant Tumukwende Abel. Number 016, Special Constable Katende Faisal. Number 40223, Detective Corporal Kwarisima Amon Mutangira Irene Bahati Mugenga Pacific Alias Ilunga Monga. Around 25th day of October 2013 at Kamengo in Pigi District along Masaka Kampala Road, while in unlawful possession of firearms and grenades, ordinarily the monopoly of the Defense Forces, conveyed one Mutabasi Joel without his consent to the Republic of Rwanda. Mutabasi Joel. Oh, I may take away your phone. Joel Aguma. Joel Aguma, have you heard and understood the statement and the particulars of the offense?
My Lord Chairman and members of this Honorable Court, and my Lord the Judge Advocate, the Register of this Court, the prosecution, and the police in the defense. And my Lord, before the accused person take plea, my Lord, we have a which we are ready to raise right now, my Lord, about the jurisdiction of this court, and secondly, my Lord, about the infringement of the constitutional rights of the accused persons whom we are representing, before they are produced for you, my lords. And we are ready to raise the objections, my lords. My lords, we are raising objection to
thought you'd have done that before even.
We are not given the
chart
sheet, my Lord.
Chart sheet will be operational when I signed it.
Yes, but now that you have read it, they are going to take a plea, but we think...
That's right, after taking plea, we shall hand over to you.
That's okay, but now before they take plea, we have objections.
So that...
We have objections. One, my Lord, we have objections. One, to the jurisdiction of this court. That's the first one. Second one, to the charges. The charges before you. And my Lord, the third one is the aspect of infringement of the constitutional rights of the accused persons, my Lord, and members of this court, before they were veiled before this court, and by end of us making these objections, we shall apply, my lords, that you be pleased to discharge and release these accused persons. And we are ready to raise our objections. Much obliged.
I am So, my hope is that you are left. I mean, you can't.
my lord, the chairman and members of the court, the other advocate, members of the bar. My lord, the Constitution provides fundamental rights for suspects. The only place where they can complain, my lord, is before the lordship. It has been brought to our attention that certain aspects of their rights guaranteed under the Constitution, long detention, torture, mistreatment. And it has also been brought, my lord, to our attention that in the course of the investigations, our clients were being asked questions geared towards incriminating some senior officers. My lord, the only place we can raise that is before you. We have no other place. And that is why we are saying we have not gone into the nitty-gritties. We have just highlighted our areas of concern as the advocate speaking.
This was, you have any responsibility or with the
My Lord Chairman, I have a lot of members. Our other colleagues have not raised the complaints. And they have not produced evidence for this on the report. But the events of the two departments have been infringed. Father, my Lord Chairman, I have a lot of members. The rights of the two departments have been infringed. They fired their complaints to the High Court, which will handle the imprisonment of the senior members.
Maybe my Lord Chairman and members of the court, judge advocates and members of the bar, what we did was we are just intending that this is what we want. We are not done. We are not ready for court. But we say we are ready to do it. And I'm now ready to raise these three objections, if it pleases court. The jurisdiction, the nature of the charges, and the infringement of the constitutional right of the case before they are brought before the court.
So let's do this, counsel.
Yes. The advisories
My Lord, you also provide a clear instruction to judge and a revelation to the king of the same rules of procedure. So, my Lord, judgment is that the judge should control us, make the attention pass to the court, and this is an idea that we know. Also write the treatment of rights of accused persons. My Lord, the rights of accused persons, as far as we are concerned, are those that concern us here. The accused persons might see us. Therefore,
Chairman and members, and the other advocate, and the bench, I mean, the bar, sorry. We are grateful for this guidance, but on the issue of infringement of the rights of the accused persons, before they are produced before you, my Lord, what kind of trial are you going to have? What kind of person? Can you just allow a person whose rights have been utterly abused to appear before you from the time he was arrested until he reached here? My Lord, I think these questions we intend to raise them because they are very fundamental questions. They might happen today with accused persons, tomorrow they might happen with any of us. And as a court of law, my Lord, we believe that courts cannot shut their eyes and just refer people for civil remedies. A civil remedy is about damages. But court cannot shut his eye. Because the only way the liberty of an individual under Article 29 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda can be infringed as set out within that article. So I think it's very, very important. Because where do they go? We can't address a press conference. We are lawyers. The accused cannot address a press conference. If they have anything, it's for the record. Court knows the people who
who have appeared before them. And for us, we intend to raise that matter now. Because he said that we don't have a problem with the guidance in putting a formal application. And of course, since now the charges have been read, we'll need to have a copy of the charge, because I deem that. I think Chairman, my lord, will have signed it. So we don't have a problem with the formal written submission. The other things. But the issue of infringement is there right now. We still pray that you give us the opportunity to raise it before. Because it's a dangerous trend which we believe as human rights lawyers and as believers in this constitution and in this court.
What do you not expect from us?
Yes,
what do you want us to